हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेसन नंबर 13, फिजिकल एंड केमिकल चेंजेस। अंडर दिस वी सीन नेचुरल चेंज, यूजफुल हार्मफुल चेंज, फास्ट एंड क्विक चेंज एंड स्लो चेंज। एंड टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग द नेक्स्ट पार्ट एंड दैट हैव अ फर्नेस। सो वी सीन अंडर दिस हाउ टू मेक द गार्लैंड विद द बैंगल्स, तोरण मीन्स वी आर सीन दैट वी सीन। Now next point is the, you made a link from the glass piece. How will you change the shape of the link to give the original shape? Okay, same thing we have to do. We have to melt it again and we have to give the its original shape. How will you restore the original candor from melting one? So for that, what we have to do, first of all we have to, that melted wax is there, we have to melt it again, and we have to give the shape of, means we have to that melted that mold of the candle, then we will get the wax candle again. Melting wax and obtain by original solid wax is again by something that can be repeatedly. The changes that can occur in forward and reverse direction. So first of all, wax we melt, and that from that melted wax we made the candle again. Okay, we made the candle again. So in this process, what happens? The wax melt, and again from that melted wax we made the candle again. So this is a reversible change. So these kind of changes are called as a reversible changes. A ripe mango, however, cannot be transformed back into the raw mango. Okay, so that is the irreversible change. Again, some examples are there. We cannot obtain the wood, okay, from the ash form after burning of the wood. When the once wood burn, it transforms into coal, otherwise ash. But from that ash, otherwise coal, we cannot get the wood again. Same like the from the ripe mango, we cannot get the raw mango again. So these kind of changes are called as a irreversible changes. What is meant by irreversible change? The changes that can take place at once only and we cannot reverse it, those are called as a irreversible changes. And give some examples of irreversible changes. So you know, so many examples are there inside it. We cannot make the milk from the curd, otherwise our growth is also a kind of, I told you before only, growth is a irreversible change. After that, once we cut the tree, we cannot make the, means again, we cannot, means join it. These are the examples of the irreversible changes. So here are some questions asking, can you tell what comes after daytime? Yes, the night time. What comes? The night time. Next, what is the next stage of after sunrise? That is sunrise is there, then sun, after what happens? It afternoon comes, then sun comes on our head. Afterwards, in evening time, sunset is there. In that way, sunrise and sunset are the steps are there. What comes after high tide? That is low tide. Next question is, the bird is sitting on a tree, flies away. A bird is sitting on a tree, flies away. So flood comes and meteor strikes across the sky. In these examples inside, some are there, what happens? Day comes, then day after, night. These are what happens periodically. After day, means every day, the sun rises at the same timing and sunsets at the same timing. So these are called as the periodic changes. So here it is given, sunrise every day, day comes, night comes day, 12 hours day, 12 hours night. In that way, what happens? We are getting this daytime and night time, one after that, after another. Here, then, in this example, high tide comes, then low tide comes after that. then bird sitting on a tree flies away. Okay, bird sitting on a tree tree and flies away means after some time, means it is not a periodically, means it will sit on this only tree. We cannot say that it will sit on any another tree also. Flooding, every year flooding is not coming. Sometimes what happens, it depends on the rain, the flood will come or not. And meteor streaking across the sky. And this is also what happens. It is not always happening. It happens sometime only. So these changes we can divide into two parts. And these are called as a periodic changes. Means those are occurring a particular interval of a time. And another it is called as a non-periodic changes. Those are occurring at some time. So here the definition of the periodic change is given. On considering above examples, we find that some changes occur again and again. Some changes occur again and again after definite interval of time. And some changes occur, those are called as a periodic changes. On the other hand, it cannot be said for sure when certain changes will recur after one occurrence. Okay? If even they recur, the time interval is not fixed, such a changes are called as a non-periodic changes. Okay? Means the changes are occurring, but there is a not definite interval of a time. Okay? It will occur, it may not occur, it will means it occur also, but time is not fixed. So, this kind of changes are called as a periodic changes. The changes occur again and again in a particular interval of time is called as a, which kind of change? That is a reversible or periodic change, and the changes that occur without any interval of time, those are called as a non-periodic changes. Now, which type of change is the seasons from summer rain to winter? Okay, these are the, means these seasons are the periodic change. You know that summer has 4 months, winter has 4 months, and the rainy season has 4 months. So, these are occur in the regular interval. And which hand of the clock shows periodic change from 6 to 6? Periodic change which shows the second hand and the minute hand. They are moving in a, after 1 minute or once, what happens? This minute hand is there, it is moving and it coming on the original position till 6. So how many times? From 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. Minute hand. And our hand also, what happens? Suppose we will take the example of our hand. From 6 to 6, it comes one time, means in the 6 a.m. to the 6 p.m., it comes at once only. But minute hand, what happens? In a, you know that in hour, how many minutes are there? 60 minutes are there. And how 6 to 6, 12 minutes are there. So 12 hours, and every hour itself, 60 minutes are there. So, what happens, this size means again that minute hand is there, in 1 hour it comes 60 times at its position to act on 12. So, this kind of changes are called as a periodic, that occurs in a regular interval of a time. Now, observe, here it is, some pictures are given. See here, this mango is raw mango and this is the ripe mango. That bird is there, it blossom into the flower, and here some materials are there which are mixed, and by using magnet the iron particles are separated from the those material. Now if you see here in this picture, the in glass ice cubes are taken and after some time it turns into the water. So here are also some changes are there. So here written some chemical and the physical changes. If you see these pictures, you will notice that we cannot, means mango, what happens, it some chemical reaction takes place inside it and that mango ripes. But ripe mango we cannot convert it into the raw mango. This we separated the iron particles or iron fillings from the substances, mixed substances, but here what happens, there is no any changes takes place in the magnet also, that particles inside also. So this is a physical change. Original substance remains as it is. That Once the flower blossom, bud blossoms and converts into the flower cannot be converted into the bud again. So this is a chemical change. And here ice melts into the water, but why water again changes? If we freeze the water, we will get the ice back again. So here in the first and the third picture inside, it shows the chemical change, and the second and fourth inside, it is the physical change, means these changes are what happens occur at once only. Which of the following changes shown in the picture alongside are temporary? Which are the temporary? So the second and the fourth, means conversion of water, ice to water, and the to take mixing of that iron filings into the another substances which are not magnetic substances, these are called as these changes are temporary. Now here, which of the changes are permanent? The mango, ripening of mango and the blossoming of the bud or flower, these are the permanent changes. Okay. Third question, in which of the changes did the original matter undergo change? In first and the third inside, original matter undergo changes. Okay, means the raw mango's taste is sour, and if you see the mango which was ripe, its taste is sweet in taste. Okay, and that that blossoming of flower also, what happens, there are some internal changes are takes place. So they are here, the original matter undergo changes in the one and the third picture. In which did the original matter remains unchanged? Now in the question number, in the second picture, if you see here, some substances are there, maybe some paper pieces are there, okay, and some maybe powder, maybe something here, maybe sulfur powder may be there, and iron fillings and iron nails are putting inside it. When we move this magnet on these substances, what happens? The magnetic substance, that is the iron nails, get attracted towards the magnet, and we are keeping it here, we are separated it, okay, and the non-magnetic substances remain inside the that dish. So here in this example inside, the separate, we substance is separated, but its original content, substance, that is iron nail inside, ferrous is there, and whatever is there, it may be sulfur powder, whatever paper pieces are there, this original constituent of the substance is not changing. And here in fourth picture also, here the ice means also H2O, and water means also H2O. So here original substance remains as it is, but its states are changing, solid to liquid and liquid to gases. Okay, so in which, here asked, in which did the original substance matter remains unchanged? So in second and fourth, the original matter remains unchanged. In which of the changes was new substance with new property form? New substance with new property, the mango and the what, the flower, these are the new substances from the form, from the old one, okay, and its properties are changes. In some of the above example of changes, the properties of original substance remain same, that is the their composition remains unchanged, no new substance is formed, such a change is called as a physical change. This is the definition of the which physical change, what they told you, that is in some above examples, in some of the properties of the original substance remains the same, that is their composition remains unchanged, no substance formed, then this such a type of change is called as a physical change. And its opposite to is, it is that the changes due to which the original, the substance is transformed into another substance, the substance is transformed into another substance having new and different properties, having new and different properties, those are called as the chemical change. Okay, so these are the this is the physical and chemical change that we had seen today, and the next part of the lesson we will see in our next lecture. So today we seen the reversible and irreversible change. The reversible change that occurs in a regular, means after a periodic, means interval of a time, reversible means that occurs again and again. Irreversible, that occurs sometime. Periodic change, that occurs reversible but periodic. It has a particular time inside it is repeating. For example, every day sunrise, sunset. Then afterwards, what we are saying, day, night, these high tide, low tide. These are the periodic changes, and the changes that are not occur periodically, those are called as the non-periodic changes. Then we see the physical change, that is the original substance of the substance remains as it is in the change. It is called as a physical change, and chemical change inside the original substance does not remain as it is. It is called as a chemical change. So today we are going to stop here only, and the next part of the lesson that we will see in discuss in our next lecture. So today we'll stop here only. All of you learn the definitions, all this whatever from this lesson, definitions are very important. So in the last lecture and this lecture, inside how many definitions are there, just note down and learn it perfectly. Okay, thank you and have a good day.